Hi, I'm Laura from Enclave Networks, and in this brief video, I'm going to show you how you can use Enclave to securely access a remote server from your home office without opening any firewall ports, deploying a VPN server, or otherwise modifying your home or remote network in any way. For the purpose of this demo, I'm running a Windows laptop locally and RDPing to a Windows server in AWS LightSail. But these two could easily be Linux or macOS devices, any network protocol is supported, web, SSH, database, etc. And the local and remote systems can be running literally anywhere that can connect out to the internet. That means Azure, Google Cloud, on-premise, at home, a Raspberry Pi on the factory floor, anywhere. If we switch to the LightSail networking tab for our server, you can see at the moment this LightSail box is open to the public internet for RDP traffic, which is really not ideal. Anyone can see the server is there and try and brute force password attempts against it. We want to drop it off the public internet, making it invisible to attackers while still allowing systems we trust to connect to it. That's where Enclave comes in. To get started, I need to install the Enclave agent on the server I wish to access. I can get the link to the Windows installer from the Enclave portal. From our website, click Login or sign up for a new free account if you haven't already. For convenience, I'm going to log in with a Microsoft account, but you can also use your Google or GitHub login or use your email. The Enclave portal lets you centrally manage all your connected systems and the policies that can control who can connect to what. To get started, we go to Enroll a New System. I'm going to download the Windows installer, then copy it to my server and run it. This is the attended form of the installer, but you can equally install Enclave on Windows in unattended mode, for example via Group Policy or System Center. So, the Enclave Tray application is now going to ask me for an enrollment key. Enrollment keys are tokens used, as you may have guessed, to enroll systems into your account and can be created in the portal. You can have as many enrollment keys as you like, each for a different purpose. Employees working from home, limited time contractors, visiting auditors. I'm going to create a new one quickly for this demo. I'm creating a new key called servers, and I'm going to set an auto tag on this key. I'm going to call that servers. Tags are a way of grouping systems, but we'll also use them in a moment to define what connectivity systems will have. Setting one or more auto tags on a key means that any system enrolled with that key is auto-assigned those tags. I'm also going to change the approval mode to automatic to skip an extra approval step during enrollment. Once the key is saved, I'll click View Key to get my new key and put it on the clipboard. Back to my server, and I'm going to paste my key in and enroll my system. Once that's done, the Enclave Tray application will update to show my new Enclave system ID and my Enclave IP address. Note that this is not the same as your local or public IP. If I go back to the Enclave portal and into the systems page, I can now see my AWS server has connected to the Enclave portal and is tagged with servers. So at this point, with the agent safely installed, I can close this server's firewall, effectively hiding it from attackers on the public internet. I'll go back to LightSail and remove the RDP port that allows public access. This RDP window connected to the public IP is now going to fail because the firewall's closed, so I will get rid of that. To get back secure access to this server, I need to install that same Enclave agent on my laptop so I can connect to the server using its Enclave IP address instead of its public IP address. As I already installed the Enclave agent on my laptop earlier, I now just need to enroll it. I previously created an enrollment key for laptops, which will tag my system with the laptops tag, so we'll use that. Once I've enrolled my laptop, it's also got an Enclave IP address. If I switch to the systems page in the portal, you can see my laptop is now visible. An important note here, just because systems are enrolled in the same account doesn't mean they can talk to each other yet. Enclave is default deny. Nothing can communicate until you define a policy that says they can. Policies let us define anything from very finely micro-segmented virtual networks all the way up to big mesh networks containing all our systems. Policies are intended to represent what connectivity a business needs without having to worry about how that connectivity happens. To create a policy, I give it a name, in this case, laptops to servers, and I specify one or more sender tags and one or more receiver tags. Let's put in the tags from the systems we enrolled a few moments ago, with laptops as the sender and servers as the receiver. This will allow systems tagged with laptops to connect to any systems tagged as servers, but not the other way around. Then I hit save, switch back to my tray application, and you can see I now have a single connection from my laptop to my server in AWS. I'm going to right-click my connection and copy the Enclave hostname, then put that into the normal Windows Remote Desktop client. Enclave comes with DNS baked in that resolves to Enclave IP addresses. You can customize your DNS names in the portal. Click connect and log in as normal. I'm just going to grab my RDP login details from off-screen and accept the standard prompts. There we go. And we're in. Connected to this server without a VPN or a public port. If at any point you don't want that connectivity, you can jump back to the portal and disable the policy. Then re-enable it when you want that connectivity back. And that's it. Setting up private network access with Enclave in about 5 minutes without changing any of your existing network. Install it for free, give it a go, and let us know what you think.